the street. Did my time, took my chances. Went the distance, now I'm back on my feet. Just a man and his will to survive. So many times, it happens too fast. You trade your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight just to keep them alive.
We'll be right back. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for showing up today. We had a little rough start this morning. We had a lot of rain last night overnight, but the field's in great shape. The game for 3 p.m. will go on as planned. But before we begin, let's pause for a moment of silence for the former members of Saddlebrook Little League who are no longer with us this year, and also the brave men and women of our armed forces who are currently protecting our country and those that have paid the ultimate sacrifice. Good afternoon, Mayor Robert White, Saddlebrook Police Department, Saddlebrook Fire Department, Saddlebrook Volunteer Ambulance Corps, Council President Florence Mazur, Councilman Andrew Semaluca, Councilman Todd Accomando, Councilwoman Karen Dominio, Councilman Dave Garrick, Deacon Anthony, our team sponsors, managers, coaches, parents, and all the players of our league. As president of Saddlebrook Little League, it's an honor and privilege to stand before you and welcome to the 66th annual Saddlebrook Little League Opening Day Parade. For 66 years, Saddlebrook Little League has been going strong with providing the youth of our community the opportunity to play America's favorite pastime sport. We will continue to teach them about teamwork, sportsmanship, and how to play the game. Saddlebrook Little League is a nonprofit organization that relies solely on its volunteers to keep it going, and I cannot stress enough what you guys mean to the league. Without volunteers, Saddlebrook Little League wouldn't be here today. Through the hard work and dedication of the executive board, and in conjunction with the players and parents over the years, we will continue to grow and keep moving forward. This time I'd like to introduce you to the executive board. We have Vice President Mark Nunziato, Secretary Vic Jaramillo, Treasurer Ed Lopez, Player Agent James Kuros, Trustees Joseph Peretti and Jessica Crin, Challengers Vice President Dawn Pallada, and for the second season, Senior Vice President of the Challengers, Teresa Kelly. These men and women behind us is the forefront of this league, and if you haven't sat in our shoes, you guys wouldn't know how much time and effort that we put into this. With that being said, I'd like to introduce to you on the third baseline people that have been in our shoes before. We have Mr. Duffy, past president, ADA District number 5. Kenny Sullivan, Billy Thomas, Bob Weber, Frank DiBella, and from District 5, also assistant DA from Lyndhurst Little League president, Bob Laverty. At this time, I'd like to call up Major Division Managers Eddie Lopez and Joe Peretti to present the 12-year-old players who are playing for their final season in Saddlebrook Little League.
Gavin Accomando. John Lanieri, he's not here right now, but I'll give this to him later. Matthew Acapinti. Angelo Benanti. He's not here. Joe Bradley. Paolo Petrosello. Brian Traverso. Ryan Cruz, see that for later. Brady Kent, Joseph Peretti.
Unico, Alex Barra.
Oh, it's under the balls. Kevin Konovich, get up here, big guy.
Daniel Colon. He's not here, but Sebastian Margono. Steven DePinto. John Gleason. Michael Tompkins. Jacob Jaramillo. And Danny Jones. Great job, guys. How does it feel? Sit. A lot of you went through 5, 6, 7, 8 years of Little League. So, get going. Get back out there. Okay, a special acknowledgement that we have to do today. Anybody remembers former member of Saddleback Little League, John Brody? John Brody passed away November of 2017. A little while after that, Saddleback Little League got a letter in the mail. Opened up the mail. And had a lot of stuff. And it named Saddleback Little League as one of his, in his will, where he left some money. Mr. Brody left Saddleback Little League an enormous, generous amount of money. So we decided that, as a board, what are we gonna do? A lot of us said, okay, fields need some work, things need to be done. We, over at Victor Field, we made that a legit 50-70 field. We converted that from 46-60 to 50-70, but you could play both there. So as you get older, the bases get a little bigger, the mound gets put back a little bit. Then you'd be moving on to your 60-90. So we converted that field, upgraded some of the turf, irrigation system, and we're gonna be doing some work over there. One of the biggest projects that we did so far, if everybody looks up, we have the new lights. It's the Musco LED retrofit kit. The lights that were put in were put back in 1994, and a couple of these gentlemen right here were probably on the board that put them on, okay? So 25 years ago, Saddleback Little League had their first lights. So with this new lighting system here, we just renewed another life of 25 years for Saddleback Little League at no expense anymore. So we're gonna continue going on with the donations that Mr. Brody gave us. We're very proud that he was a part of the program, and we're gonna pay it forward to him. If anybody turns around, you will see that there's a new fence, new foul poles. We went from the 8-foot fence down to the 4-foot fence, so all the fans can watch the games out there, and they're going to enjoy the game from the parking lots. Wouldn't be an opening day ceremony without one little mix-up. Okay, this time I'd like to call Deacon Anthony from St. Philip the Apostle for a special prayer for the 2019 season.
Thank you. I'd just like to say it's an honor to be here. You know, I went to school in grammar school right over there at Smith School, It was called Cambridge School when I first started attending that. And as a child, I played for Inching Company Number 2. We wore wool uniforms back then. We didn't have these these uniforms. It was back in the day. But it's so great to be here because I was involved in this parade. I was talking with the mayor, Bobby White. We were here when we were kids, and we did the same thing. So it really is a privilege to be here. And then we moved on up to Babe Ruth and Mickey Mantle down at the other field. So thank you for having me. And as we come together in prayer, let us remember that we're all children of God, no matter what faith we come from. And so let's ask Heavenly Father, we ask of your blessing for this baseball season that is about to begin. Give each one of us the courage to play this game in the manner which our words and actions are pleasing to you. Let us enter into the season of competition in the spirit of sportsmanship and respect for others and the members of opposing teams. And we ask you, Father, to bless each one of us, especially the players, their parents, the coaches, and officials. Father, keep us under your protection and help us to be aware of your presence throughout this season. Thank you. Amen. Have a safe and wonderful season. God bless you.
Thank you, Deacon Anthony. Vic Jaramillo, if you come to the podium and introduce the team sponsors and names.
Yeah, Eddie Lopez will do it.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to announce basically the manager, but we do have several coaches that are here also, but just to keep things moving, I will announce the teams, the sponsors, the managers, and when I announce the team, let's hear who could be the loudest, all right? So starting with Clinic 4, we have Otterstedt Insurance. Brian Anthony Landscaping. And We Print Marketing. So for T-Ball, manager Patrick Carberry, Dr. Mully. We have John Buds from Elite Sound Entertainment. Todd Minimi, Modells. And Dalibor Jasnik from TLC. Coach Pitch, manager John Wave, Care One. Midland Brewhouse, manager Dan DiBella. Enzo's Pizza, manager Deani Batanzas. Player Pitch, manager Edward Tedesco, VFW. Manager Michael Sabelski, PBA. Our minors division, we have four teams. Phoenix Flooring, manager Matt Bennis. Hook and Ladder, manager Mark Nunziato. Engine 2, manager Vic Jaramillo. And Engine 1, manager Frank Ranieri. Majors Division, Handsome Devils, manager Joe Peretti. And Unico, manager Eddie Lopez.
Thank you, Eddie. Moving on to programming, I'd also like to thank Bobby Hickshaw and the members of the DPW, Chief Robert Kugler and the members of the Saddlebrook Police Department, Fire Chief Chris Sloma and Assistant Chief Joe Palazzani, and the members of the Saddlebrook Volunteer Fire Department, Captain Harry Reed, and the members of the Saddlebrook Volunteer Ambulance Corps for their assistance today in the parade and the safety of our players throughout the season. At this time, I'd like to call Mayor Robert White to come up and say a few words.
Thank you, John. And welcome, everyone, to the Little League opening day. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm not gonna say too much, I'm gonna be brief because we have an exciting program ahead. I just wanna thank everyone for attending, and special thanks to the Saddlebrook Police Department, the DPW, the Fire Department, and the Ambulance Corps for their assistance today with the parade and all they do for us. The council and I always love opening day baseball because of the warm weather, spring-like weather we're having. And but most importantly, the sounds of kids having fun playing baseball and whatever other fun things they're doing. I want to thank Little League President John Tuohy and the executive board for all they do. They do an awesome job. Their commitment and leadership has brought Little League baseball in town forward, and we've progressed a lot under their leadership. With the support of managers, coaches, parents, Little League has become a better program and a more positive experience for everyone that's involved. Youth sports and recreation is very important part of Saddlebrook, and Little League has led the way, teaching our kids the fundamentals of baseball. They've also, more importantly, have taught our youth teamwork and good sportsmanship. I say this every year because it's so important. Youth sports builds character by instilling values like discipline, hard work, sacrifice, and teamwork. All keys to success later on in life when you become an adult. So on behalf of the township, I wish everyone the best of luck for a safe and successful season. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor White. And again, I'd like to thank you and the township. Pete Lodico, I know I saw Pete Lodico here earlier, but I want to thank the mayor and council for their underlying support that they give to Saddlebrook Little League. At this time, I'd like to call up Dylan Jaramillo, Justin Quiros, and a few other players. Come on, recite the Little League pledge. Great job, boys. Very proud of you. You know, it's not easy at a young age to come up here and talk in front of everybody, but you guys did a fantastic job. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, the past few years, we brought a former New York Yankee, New York Mets to the field to come up to say a few words to the boys and girls of our program. At this time, it gives me the honor to introduce to you, from the 1969 World Series, New York Mets, Mr. Ed Cranepool. Just a quick bio on Ed. Ed is an American former baseball player. He spent his entire Major League Baseball career for the New York Mets. He was predominantly a first baseman and also played in the outfield. Ed was born in the Bronx. He attended James Monroe High School, where he began playing baseball and basketball. And at the age of 17, Ed was signed as an amateur free agent. Ed batted left, threw lefty. He made his Major League debut September 22nd, 1962, and he stayed in New York Met until September 30th, 1979, where he had his last Major League appearance. His batting average was .261. He had 118 home runs. Ed, something that we talked about before with David Wright, he had one of his records were broken. It took him over 40-something years. But Ed still holds the record for New York Mets for the most game played, and it's 1,853 games. So ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you Mr. Ed Cranepool.
Thank you very much, John. It certainly is a pleasure for myself to be invited to the opening day. 66 years is something to be proud of, so you have to appreciate the parents' support and the board of directors here that have supported this league for so many years. As a member of the Mets, I played 18 years in the major leagues and for an organization that I was involved in two World Series. So I know what it's like to be on a good team and a bad team. I had a lot of years that were pretty tough. So you young fellows that are playing in a sport that you love, you get out on the field every day, you participate, you have fun. Little League Baseball should be a learning curve. You get out here and you do the best you can every day, and the next day is another day. You forget about it. Winning is not the most important thing. You strive to win. If you lose, you just work a little bit harder. You only get out of sports as much as you put into it. So we want you kids to enjoy the game of baseball, have fun, and hopefully you can help the Mets and the Yankees in the coming years. This league has been around for a long time, and it's certainly a pleasure to be here to welcome the kids in the start of the season. This is our 50th anniversary of the 69 Mets. So we're doing an awful lot of events this year, and it's always good to come out and say hello to the Met fans that supported us all these years. So my congratulations to everybody. I want to wish all the youngsters good luck this year. You know, have a good season. Take care of your arms and legs. Prepare yourself. Warm up properly. Learn your fundamentals of the game. Enjoy yourselves. And have a great season. Thank you.
Thank you, Ed. So, ladies and gentlemen, Ed Cranepool is going to be throwing out the first pitch. Cranepool will be off the field, sitting behind a table and chair, and be signing autographs. Anybody has anything that they want autographed. I'd also like to say thank you for his donation, A Night to Remember. Owner Michael LePerry, I'd like to thank Charles LePerry for donating his time for opening day, for DJing the music. Thank you very much.
Just a quick announcement. Coaches and coaches' hats will be given away right over here outside of the visitors' dugout. Pass it over to Lorraine Tui. She got a nice announcement.
For all of you who know me, I don't like to speak in front of people, but how about we give a round of applause to John? He has worked effortlessly, selflessly for this program. He's up at night, he volunteers his time, he does whatever he can for the program and for the children of this town.
Thank you, Lorraine. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes this year's ceremony. Let's have a safe season, and remember, it's all for the kids. Why? Baseball. No other games comes close. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Have a great season. First game here is at 3 p.m. Handsome Devils versus Unico.
Back on the street. Did my time, took my chances. With the distance, now I'm back on my feet. Just a man and his will to survive. So many times, it happens too fast. You trade your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight just to keep them alive. We'll be right back.